Okay, so one of the good things about processing is that it has all these different libraries available. And basically, that's just code that someone else has written so that you don't have to. So to find all these different libraries, you can go to the reference section of processing.org and then click on libraries. And because processing is built on Java, there's a lot of stuff available that was originally written for Java and then kind of made available to processing through this libraries mechanism. So in the first half of this page, you'll see all of these libraries that are used so much by so many people that they just decided to include them in processing. So we don't have to download them. Then if you look further down, and that includes things like Minim for creating sound or reading sound files, listening through the microphone, OpenGL for creating 3D stuff, video for video playback and recording, making PDF files, opening SVG files, which are like vector graphics from Illustrator, and communicating with microcontroller, opening XML files, that kind of stuff. So things that are maybe less common end up in this other section, which is stuff that other people have made available on their own websites. So if I look, for example, under the graphic interface section, these are just ways of making buttons and text fields and things like that. So I could just try out any one of these and see which one I like best. So if I look back at, here's one for sound. If you use Super Collider, then this would be useful. And I'll show you how to install a library. You basically just click on it and it'll launch you into their website, whoever the author is. And the reason why I'm showing you how to install these is because most of the websites have like outdated instructions for how to install libraries because they're based on how processing used to work. This one's actually correct, but a lot of them are old and broken. So this is the right process. The first step is, to find the library page, click on download, and that should download a zip file containing everything. And there it is. So Safari has already unzipped it for me. There's the folder, and usually the folder name is the same as the library name. If I open it, there's an examples folder. Hopefully, there's definitely a library folder, and sometimes there's a source folder. Sometimes there'll be other stuff, and sometimes people don't follow this convention, and you'll find something in here like installation instructions, and it won't quite look like this. But most of them look like this. So to install them is pretty easy. You basically just need to find, first of all, your sketchbook folder, which is like where all of your sketch folders end up. So if I wasn't sure how to find that, maybe I would go into processing and go under preferences, and it tells me right there, there's my sketchbook location. So pretty easy to find on, in my case, it's just under documents processing. And if you look in there, there's all these sketches that I've made before, but then there's also something called libraries, and it has to look just like this, lowercase l, and with IES at the end. And you probably don't have this, but just create it. And the way that you install that library that I just downloaded is to just take that folder and drag the whole thing into libraries. That's it, it's installed. There's one final step, which is that if you had processing open already, you have to restart it, or it won't recognize the new library. So I'll open processing again. And the next thing to do is probably to go under File, and you would think it would be under Examples, which is where you'll find examples for the other libraries that are already installed in processing. But if you want to find examples for libraries that you've installed, you have to go to the Sketchbook menu, go all the way down to Libraries, which is off the screen in your case, and then for each of the libraries that you've installed, you'll see an Examples section in there. So that's the first thing to do is just I'll go into examples for one of the Super Collider sketches, and I just have to start looking. Hopefully there are comments in here to help me understand how to use it, and then I'll just start looking through the code and try and figure it out, make changes to this, and try and get it to do what I want. So that's the whole process of installing libraries. Bye-bye.